What's up, LTD addicts? It's Dave here, back with another lifetime deal review. Today, we are talking about chatbots. Of course, we're talking about chatbots. In 2023, all anyone is allowed to talk about on YouTube is chatbots. Now, I'm kidding, of course, but it does feel that way sometimes. However, this product, I think, is actually a fairly cool idea. We're going to be reviewing it in this video. Essentially, what you're in for is a chatbot that's powered by OpenAI and ChatGPT. And you can train it on your own data so that your customers can ask questions about your products and services. Sound good? All right, let's get right to it. So here we are over on AppSumo. The product is called Chatbase, and I do have a link for that down below in the description. It starts off at just $29, a one-time fee. We can go to the plan details here and see that actually there is a license tier 2, which is going to be tempting to many people, myself included. This is the one that I picked up. So just a quick breakdown of the different tiers. With tier 1, you're going to get 10 chatbots and 1,000 message credits per month. So I feel like the limits here are a little bit on the low side. 1,000 credits could go by pretty quick if you have a pretty populated website. With tier 2, that goes up to 5,000 credits per month, but more importantly, you can connect your own OpenAI API key, which will allow you essentially unlimited access. Now, of course, you will have to pay for usage of that API key, but I think that is probably what most people in my shoes are going to want, so they can offer this as a service to their clients. We also get 40 chatbots, which means for $159, you could serve 40 different clients. Another big distinction is that with tier 2, the Chatbase branding is removed, which is ideal. Most people don't want to have another company's branding on their own website, especially if you're serving clients. All right, I already went ahead and picked up my license, so I'm going to go right over to Chatbase here and let's dig in. I'm going to click on my account in the upper right-hand corner. I'm already logged in and we can see my plan details here. I do have the $159 lifetime account, all of the specs that we just talked about. There is a usage setting here where I can see those 5,000 credits per month, and then I can connect my OpenAI API key right here, which I've not done yet, but maybe I'll do by the end of the video if it's necessary. Finally, there's a section here for API keys. I assume this is to integrate third-party services, although I haven't really figured that out yet. We will dig into that by the end of the video. All right, let's get started by creating our very own chatbot. So I'm going to go up to the My Chatbot section in the menu here. We'll click and add a new chatbot. Now I have 4 different sources that I can use. I can use a file, so I can upload something like a PDF here as long as it's been OCR'd. As they mentioned here in the little copy, the way to check if it's been OCR'd is if you can select the text when you open up the PDF, you should be good to go. We can also just copy and paste plain text right in here. So if you've got transcripts of videos, things like that, you could dump it right in. Or you can have it crawl your website, which is what I'm going to start with, actually. So I'm going to go have it crawl my agency website here. We'll type in clientamp.com and choose fetch links. You can see it is now crawling the website. It's about 3% done. We'll wait for this to complete and see what it comes back with. All right, so that completed pretty quickly here. You can see it found a list of all of the different URLs on my website. I'm going to go ahead and include those links and we'll create the chatbot. All right, great. Here we are. The chatbot is trained and ready to go based on the information that's available on my website. Let's ask it a few questions. I want to move my site off of Kajabi. I'm not actually going to ask a question to start with. I'm just going to make a statement because I think customers kind of do this sometimes, like, hey, this is what I want to do. And they expect you to infer a question from that statement. All right, pretty good answer here. It says, great, ClientAmp can help migrate your site from Kajabi to an open source platform like WordPress or WooCommerce. We specialize in managing and optimizing leading open source platforms, and we can help you harness their potential without surrendering control of your future. Would you like more information on our website management services? That's an excellent answer. I'm pretty happy with that. For now, I'm going to say no, but what about Amazon SES? I can't get out of sandbox mode. It says, sorry to hear that you're having trouble getting out of sandbox mode. Our Amazon SES setup service can help you with that. Our team typically works with Amazon SES support, and we can get you out within 24 to 72 hours. This is all very accurate information. It says that you'll get a full refund if we can't get you out of sandbox mode. Again, something that is true. So very impressed here. And again, it offers to tell you more about the service. So that is really cool. There's some sources available down here so I can see where it's actually pulling that information from. I'm impressed. This is pretty high quality stuff. All right, let's have a look around the settings tab. I'm up here on the top where it says settings. This is again for that same chatbot that we just set up. I can give it a name here. So if I wanted to call it the client amp bot, I could do that. Then we've got a system message, which is essentially the message that the bot gets in the background. So the user doesn't have to say this. It's instructing the bot on how to answer. So it's saying, have a conversation. You're a document. Your name is AI assistant, and you're going to provide me with answers from the info in the document. If it's not included, just say, I'm not sure, and stop after that. So it's not going to speculate wildly or make things up, ideally. Of course, we all have used ChatGPT and had it just come up with wild and crazy answers. So hopefully this has reined in quite a bit, but we'll have to use this over some time to find out how accurate it is. Next, we've got a temperature slider here. I can move it all the way up to creative, which is a 1. Down to reserved, which is a 0. I recommend if you're using this on a professional website, you probably want to keep it around the 0 mark, maybe 0.1 to keep it nice and reserved and only give factual information. If you pump that up to a 1, I bet it's a lot more likely that it's going to start hallucinating information about your website. Next up, we've got some visibility options. Right now it is set to private, which means no one can access this except for me when I'm logged into my account. So what I'm going to do is switch this over to private, but can be embedded on a website, which I think is kind of the sweet spot. I can make it completely public, but I just want this to live on my website. So that's a good option here. And I'm going to go ahead and add this to both our domain, so clientamp.com, as well as the domain that we use for our clients to log into their account. So if you're an existing client, you would go to portal.clientamp.com. You do have the option to set some rate limiting, which is important because you don't want some spammer to come in and just use up all of your API credits, especially if you're connecting this up to your own OpenAI account, and they would actually just be spending your money wildly. So there's really good to see there's rate limiting here. You can set that to be as strict as you want. Right now it's set to 20 messages every 240 seconds, which I think is actually quite a few messages. Then down below here, we can go ahead and actually set up how our chatbot looks. I'm going to go ahead and add a profile picture here. All right, there we go. I just added our logo in the upper left-hand corner. And now I added our display name in, so it just says client and bot here. I want to be really obvious that you're chatting with a bot and not a real human. And let's go ahead and change the user color here. I kind of like this right now because it looks like iMessages, but we can go ahead and make it a green bubble if you want as well. For now, I'm going to stick with the stock blue color. All right, that looks pretty good. Next up, we can change the chat icon, which is going to be this little icon right here. I like it right now. I'm going to change the color to match our brand a little bit more. I'll choose other here, and I'm just going to choose, I wish it had a hex color here, which maybe it does. There we go. Perfect. I'm going to go ahead and just set this to be a little bit of a off black. All right. So very subtle change, but it matches the rest of our website. And finally, under settings, we can have it show an initial message after 3 seconds is the default. If you do want to disable that, you can set it to 0. I'll leave it at the default of 3 seconds and hit save changes. In the dashboard here, you can see all of the conversations that people have been having with your chatbot. Of course, this is the one that you just saw me have a moment ago. I can export this if I'd like to. I want to point out here in the settings, I might have missed this, is that we can actually have this collect email addresses as well, which I'm going to turn on right now. So collect email address will set yes, and I'm going to save this once again. Now I could go into the dashboard here. If I collect someone's email address, I'd be able to see the actual conversation they had and maybe reach out to them and follow up. We can add additional sources here, which is really good to see. You're not just limited to that website. We could upload some files. Maybe you have some sales documents you want to upload. You could do that right here, and then the chatbot would know everything that you know. This is a really great way to outsource your sales process. Now, I looked at the files, the text, and the website, but I stopped before this last option. So let's go ahead and check this out. This is a Q&A section. What is that like if I hit add here? All right, then I can just add a question and an answer. So if you've got a frequently asked questions, you can dump that all in here, and then the chatbot will be trained on the type of answers that you'd like to give for those frequently asked questions. All right, our final three options here are to embed this chatbot on our website. We can share the chatbot with other people, which would basically link them to the Chatbase website. You have to make the chatbot public for that to happen. So I'm going to leave that off for now. Or you know what? Let's turn that on. Let's go ahead and see what this looks like. So this just gives us a link to our chatbot. I'll open this up in a new tab here. There we go. It's just a full screen. I'm not really a big fan of how it doesn't open up in some kind of a constricted view. So it's a little bit better of a chat interface. But that'd be a quick way to just get people using your chatbot if you just wanted to link them to it to ask questions about your products or services. Now, what I'm actually interested in is getting this up on my website. So let's go ahead and click on embed on website. And I've got two options here. I can use an iframe, or there's a script here, which is going to put the bubble at the bottom of your screen. So I'm going to go ahead and just grab this script and I'll drop it into my website and we can see what it looks like. So I'm using WP Codebox to manage my scripts. However, you add things like a Google Analytics code to your website, you'd want to follow that same procedure here. I'm going to go ahead and add a new script. I'll call it Chatbase. We'll dump in the script once I choose JavaScript. We'll paste it in here. It says don't include script tags. This does come with script tags on it. So I'll get rid of the starting and ending script tag. The one in the middle are good. We can leave those. We'll hit save here. I'm going to go ahead and enable this. And let's go ahead and check out the front of the website and see if this is showing up. Sure enough, there it is. It's blending right in with that background. Maybe I do want to change that to a different color here to stand out. But overall, looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and give it a try. All right, pretty cool. Right away, it asks for my email address. I like to see that for me because I want to generate leads for this business. But if you don't, you just want people to engage, you could, of course, turn that off. I guess one customization I'd like to see is maybe to wait a little bit to ask for the email address. Maybe wait till they indicate that they're interested in services and want a human to follow up. Right now, it's just that single checkbox in the settings to turn this feature on, but I'm glad it's there nonetheless. I do want to see where the email address goes, so let me enter my email address in here. We'll send it. It says email saved. Back over in Chatbase, I'm going to check out the dashboard here and see if we can find the actual email address. There it is right at the top. All right, that's cool. I exported this conversation and it actually pulls open a JSON file. So not extremely user-friendly here. It does show the entire text of the conversation, but probably not in a format that's really easy for most humans to read. So that could probably be improved as well. Remember at the beginning of the video, I mentioned that there's an API section down here at the bottom where I can generate an API key. Well, there's an API item up here in the menu. And if I click on that, there's five different APIs that you can use to interact with Chatbase. So the idea here is that you can actually create, update, delete chatbots, as well as chat with them through the API. So if you're a developer, these things will be very attractive to you. There's plenty of documentation here. So I feel like this is fairly good documentation to understand. If you're not a developer like me, you might want to dump some of this information into ChatGPT and have it assist you as you connect an API. Overall, I'm really happy with this product. I'm impressed with the quality of the chat output, and that is the number one feature that I want to see out of a chatbot. However, there are a few features that I think need to be integrated in order to make this a very valuable product for agency owners. First of all, I'd love to see subaccounts so that when I create a chatbot, I can go ahead and share that with a client and then they can add their own training data. That seems like a no-brainer to me. Hopefully it's coming in the future. The next thing I'd like to see is the ability to go ahead and take those email addresses that it's collecting and then shuttle it off to a CRM or an email autoresponder so that they actually get into your sales pipeline. That also seems like a necessity. And the last thing would be a nice to have, although they do have an API right now, and that is a way to automatically crawl your content. So maybe I have a podcast feed or a blog. Why can't it update that every week or maybe even every day, check for new posts and train the bot on that data automatically? That would be a really cool thing to see. However, right now you'd have to do it manually. So if you've got 40 of these bots going and they're all on different websites, getting those updates going is could take a decent chunk of time each week. But overall, I'm really happy with the quality of the product. Excited to deploy this not only on my website, but my clients' websites as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and give this one a score. We're gonna rate it an 8.8 out of 10. Highly usable right now with definitely a little bit of room for improvements. All right, go ahead and check this one out if you're interested. I've got a link down below in the description that will be my affiliate link. So clicking it and making a purchase will support me. However, all of the opinions in this video are my own. Hopefully you found the demonstration helpful and let me know if you have any questions. I'll be checking the comments down below. All right, thanks for watching. If you're not already, be sure to subscribe and I will see you in the next one.